Worthwhilers, welcome. We are 13 sleeps away from race day morning. How exciting is this? The countdown is truly on now. Before we get into today's vid, I just want to thank everyone who's been supporting the Worthwhile. Please, if you're watching this, do me a favor, hit the like button, drop us a comment, subscribe to the channel if you're new. I really appreciate it. Shout out to everyone, Benny, Knowles, Jono, the people that have been leaving comments, and shout out to everyone who's been watching in general. Show some love because it really makes a big difference for the channel. Anyway, today we're checking in on a Monday. It's a non-running day for me, so I don't usually do Monday check-ins, but I've been meaning to talk about some of the nutrition and gear that I'll be using in the race, the Melbourne Marathon 2023. The first thing I want to talk about is my race shoes. So in my Canberra Marathon last year, my debut, my only road marathon that I've done, I wore the Nike Vaporflies. Really enjoyed them. I've had two pairs of them. I've got a PB, but that's what happens when you're debuting, automatic PB. So the question was, what shoes am I gonna wear in this race? Now, you may know, or you may remember in some of my previous episodes, I've talked about the Mizuno Wave Rebellion Pros, which I got. It was a funny debacle with getting these, but I got them and I wore them in the race, Run Melbourne Half Marathon. 88 minutes, that was a big PB for me. I mean, I rate these shoes. They have only got a few Ks on them. There's no reason I couldn't wear these in the marathon. However, I have made a decision to aim for another race shoe for the big day. If I can unveil these now, it's the Alpha Fly, baby. I've always wanted to try the Alpha Flies. I mean, just look at these fine specimens right here. They're light as a feather and they look fantastic. As you know, it is a fashion show. No, it's not. Happened to be a good colorway, so I'm very happy about that. But the thing is, I haven't worn them yet. I've got to try them out. The golden rule, nothing new on race day. They must be tested and I've got to see if they're going to work for me before I make my decision. So I've got the Wave Rebellions. I've tested them out. I've raced in them. I've worn them in. Need to do that with these this week. A bit of rain on the forecast, so I don't really want to take them out in the rain. They're too nice and new and fresh. You could eat off the soles of these things right now. But it must be done regardless before the race. We're running out of time, so I'll be checking out these. If they work for me, if they're as good as I think they're going to be, these will be my race shoes, the Alpha Fly 2s. But I do have a backup which I can go to. The other thing I wanted to cover off is nutrition. So obviously I'm going to be carved up. During the race though, I will be carrying gels. I'm gonna have the Morton gels, the caffeine and the regular. I'll be carrying some of these with me. And then if I'm lucky, I'm going to have a mate of mine kind of crewing for me on the day with some drinks. So I want to avoid, if I can, ideally the chaos of the drink stations. I'll go and get some water if it's convenient and I really need it, or you know, either or. But the plan is for one of my mates to have some set out positions. They're gonna meet me with some pop tops, which I will have pre-packed with some of this Morton caffeine drink mix, which I've also gut tested all of this stuff on my ultra training. So I know it works for me. And I'm gonna be taking these drinks at probably three spots during the race, getting some carbs, caffeine, and fluid into me at some choice moments, probably, you know, roughly 10, 20, 30 Ks in, but I have a few gels on me, and yeah, that's gonna be my nutrition. So the prep is really getting serious at this point, and yeah, I'm just, I can't wait. But anyway, we'll see you tomorrow for the CC session. It's the Yasso 800s. We'll see you there. Ooh, look at them clouds. All right, it's bike boy, bike boy. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when he dings at you? Now have a look at the track here. Ooh. We're about to do an 800 session with the crew. They'll all be coming over here soon, but these puddles go all the way across. It's about to be a splash fest. Okay, so it's 10 times 800, 2 minute recoveries. Let's get it done through the water. Three down, how are we feeling, gang? All right, loving it. If your socks aren't squishy yet, you're all doing right. It wrong. We've got seven done, way to go, gang. Crushing. The crew is in amazing form. That's 10 by 800. The Yassos Everyone's fit as F. Now it's time for Parma night. We'll see you over there.
For those of you who are not racing next weekend at Melbourne Marathon, you want to come and cheer on everyone when we hit the 18 or 32 kilometre mark, I believe. Organise to drop your beer with Huda so Huda can have a beer for you, Johnny.
renowned for now being a very encouraging person. Who's really taken to the what the crew is all about, which is that mutual support, helping others, not just worrying about themselves all the time and being selfish. Has also taken a step up and done a coaching course, has joined the coaching group, or will be joining the coaching group, and has been nominated for the help that this person has done pacing others to other events, in other events. And from what I've seen, had a very successful first up year for South Melbourne. And Sean, congratulations.
Yeah, boy. Well deserved, mate.
That's all good. That was a little bit popular, wasn't it?
All right, Wednesday night, week 12, and we are here with a special event Nike have put on. There's Jenna. We're going to be training with the man himself, Steve Moneghetti, doing a mono fartlek session out on the lakeside track. So this is a special one. Let's go and check this out.
I'd like to welcome you here to a special night on our Wednesday night training, which is our mono fartlek night.
Thank you very much. Obviously, I'm humbled and I'm delighted that we finally got it to the app. So, you know, it's a session that I'll give you a bit of a history, and I actually brought my 1983 diary, so that is really genuinely my running diary from 1983, and this was presented to me by Chris Wardlaw. He took over my coaching on the 12th of March 1983, and the first thing he did, he lived in Melbourne, I was in Ballarat, first thing he did was he gave me that actual diary and said, I want you to write and record your training. Up until then, I'd just been writing it on a fool's cap piece of paper and giving it to my only other coach that I've had, which is a guy called Tony Benson in Ballarat. So he gave me that diary, 12th of March, and I said, oh, what do I do this week? And he said, oh, well, on Tuesday night you do fartlek. And I said, oh, okay, good, what do you mean? He said, oh, you know, you're sprinting and jogging. And I'm going, what? And he sort of says, oh, some minutes, you know. And anyway, we started talking about something else, and I was writing it down, and I kind of said, oh, how long? And he said, 20 minutes. So I kind of was writing stuff down while we were talking about other facets of my training, what I was going to do. Anyway, after about 10 minutes, I said, oh, look, I've got something here. If you add 90 seconds on the front and you do the same recovery, and he said, does that add up to 20 minutes? I said, yep. He said, that's fine. And that's exactly where it came from. So there's no science to it, nothing, no rocket science. It's pretty just basic. But the one thing I will say, and I could talk all night about it, but I'll try and narrow it down to a couple of sort of minimal stories. That I the first time I ever did it, and I photocopied the page, so 15th of March 1983, and I do it around Lake Wendouree. So, sorry, I'm getting older, in my glasses. So you probably know it's 2 by 1.5 minutes, 4 by 1 minute, 4 by 30 seconds, 4 by 15 seconds, all with the same recovery. A total of 20 minutes with jogs, 10 hard, 10 easy. This is direct from my diary. Almost completed a lap of the lake. So that's 6K. So almost completed the lap of the lake. Thus a very pleasing session to get so far in 20 minutes with the easy jogs included. That was when I was 21. I eventually got it down to, we went through the 6K lap. Troopy and I went through in 17:18 one night for 6K. So I was probably running 250K pace or just over. Now that's with the jogs and the recovery. I'm not sure how slow the jogs were, not very slow, obviously. So We didn't have GPSs when I was doing this in the 80s and the 90s. So you must have measured out. All we did was we measured what we went through the lap in, and obviously we kept going till we finished the 20 minutes. So it's time-based. You can do it anywhere in the world. There are no excuses, and you can do it within your comfort zone. And Dave's exactly right. Don't smash it tonight. You know what I mean? It's only training. I was running 200 Ks a week. I was doing enough volume that this was very specific for me. This was my fast session. This made me the good 5K runner that I was. The rest of my week, or most of it, except for the other couple of sessions I would do, 180K of that was just jogging around at, for me, a 4 minute K pace, but relative to you, you know what I mean. If you're a sprinter, if you want to run a good 1500, you can do my fartlek session. I don't call it monofartlek, it's just my fartlek, or normal fartlek. As long as you're doing the session and it's 20 minutes, make it work for you. But I became one of the best marathon runners in the world. Of course it's a good session. It's the best session you can do. And the results prove it. So that's a bit of the history of what I did and how I did it regularly. And it was part of my training that made me the athlete that I was. But it's something that I'm really proud of. And I'm so humbled and honoured that you would come tonight and be able to enjoy the session with me and do it in what's relative to you, and you get some real benefit out of it. So thanks for coming.
Albert Park wind is no good for my audio, but
here we are.
Put us on the recovery. This on off session, my monofartlek. Woo! I'm waiting for Mono to lap me so I can get some footage of him. Well, Mono came up behind me so quickly, I couldn't even get a shot of his face, he was just gone. Thanks, Mona. Well done, guys. Woo. So we're all done here. We did the Mona fartlek session with the man himself, Steve Moneghetti. How good was that? We'll have tempo, the last tempo tomorrow night, only 8K, so we'll see you there. Okay, week 12, it's Thursday and we are doing a tempo, but only 8Ks. I'm testing out the race wheels. Gotta wear them in, bloody rain, they're gonna get all dirty. God damn it. But anyway, they're gonna get ruined eventually. It may be raining on race day, so just have to suck it up. Poor alphas are getting dirty. With the boys and the girls and guys, we just finished our final tempo.
Already.
And some treats.
Getting the sugar
straight
in.
From Coles.
We're not sponsored by Coles, but we will take some sponsorship money. Well done, everybody. We're all ready to go. Now we just have to rest up. The new shoes, the race shoes felt good. The legs are still beat up, but aerobically that was good. The shoes feel fantastic, ready to roll. They're definitely going to be the race shoe. They didn't get too dirty in the rain, so hey. Anyway, that's it for Thursday. It's nice being in daylight savings as well. We'll see you on the weekend. Okay, we are at Savers on Sydney Road looking for some start line outfits and some interesting garments to give to our crew, our on-course crew, so we can recognize them in the crowd. So we've got to pick out some special numbers. Let's see what we can find.
What do you think, Benny? Ooh, K-Mac, yes. That could be the one. It's meant to keep you warm though. That's not gonna keep you warm.
No, I'm gonna for Ben.
Ah, for Ben, okay. Benny?
You're not gonna miss him in that.
I'm thinking maybe a t-shirt might be more appropriate. Let's, ooh. What about this one, Benny? Nice pink dressing gown type scenario. What about this one? This looks cozy and identifiable. K-Max found a cozy number. Fluffy clouds, $4.
Three.
Wow. That is it. Look at this. Little dog dogs. And a polar bear.
$8 there.
Sold. What if I put Benny in this shirt? That's pretty, that's not too offensive for him and noticeable. I think I found a Benny. Preston Bullance, $3. That's got your name written all over it. But Benny, this is coming to you with the drink bottles. Worthwhilers, good morning. It's Sunday. This time next week, the race is on. But I'm on my way to Albert Park. The last Sunday run of the training series come so far, and it's nearly time. So haven't run for 2 days because so did sessions. Tuesday we did the Yassos, Wednesday we did the Monofartlek, Thursday we did the tempo. So I took 2 days off, got to actually rest the legs. I've only done 27K so far this week, but it's all been pretty high intensity. So the volume's actually going to be dropping a little more than planned, but for very good reason. We got 16K on today, 43, 45 tops for the week, and that's gonna be just fine. And that is gonna be our week 12, wrapped up in a neat little package. Okay, we are off on our final Sunday training run. Got a good group, 16K only. It's gonna feel like nothing. We're all primed and ready.
With Jeremy around.
Freshening up, feeling good, sun's out. What more could you ask for? How are you feeling before the big one, Ted? Ready to roll?
Nervous, but yeah, ready to roll.
Definitely. Nervous, energy, that's what you want?
Yeah, definitely.
If you weren't nervous, it would be something would be wrong, so. All right, get yourself a drink, let's go.
There we go.
What a day for it.
Awesome.
All right, we're in the last couple of Ks. Our last Sunday training run. It's almost a bit sad.
It is.
I don't want it to be over. But anyway, we've got the race to look forward to. It's going to be a celebration of all our hard work. That's it. So, time to get excited for the big day. We are back at the lake.
I'm ready now.
We're excited. We're ready to party next weekend.
Ah, here he is. What are we making here? What do we call this, Johnny?
It's called
toast.
Yeah, toast. It's raw toast, but I'm reconstructing
it. It's what you do with it, you know, as Daryl Kerrigan says.
For the fearless runner,
is it ever big?
Our fearless run leaders have worked hard. They're having a nice barbie over here. It was the last Sunday, we got it done, and we'll be back on Wednesday next week. I mean, the race will almost be over this time next week. So anyway, that's the end of week 12. It's been amazing. We'll see you for race week, and then we'll have the big race recap, of course. Wow, it's been a long road, and we're nearly there. Let's go.